Hello everyone, this is Dr. Shoaib Ansari. In this video, we will be discussing about how to make an effective timetable, how to do time management, which is very important for any competitive exams. Okay, so let's start. We all know that all the successful people and all the normal people, all of us have only 24 hours a day. The difference between successful people and the unsuccessful ones are how they manage and utilize their time effectively. So why timetable is so important? Timetable kind of removes the randomness from your life. What do I mean by that? You should know. You should clearly know what you are gonna achieve, what you are trying to achieve in the next 1 year. Suppose you have an exam in December, so you should be knowing your strategy, your plan for the next 1 year, and then you will be knowing how you will approach that thing. So it removes that randomness and it creates a prepared mind when you wake up. When you wake up, you will be knowing the tasks you have to do for the day, and it acts as a GPS toward your goal. You will be knowing in the journey towards your goal, where are you standing? Are you lagging behind? Are you on time? Are you forward? So all these things are important. So how will you make a timetable? Timetable is basically a plan to achieve a goal which you have set. Okay, so your plan should have multiple sub plans, like you have a long term plan, monthly plan, weekly plan and daily plan. You should know, in next 1 year I am going to complete all this, in 1 month I will do this, in 1 week I will do this, today I will do this. So the daily plan is the most important plan, because today is the only thing you have in your control. The tomorrow you don't know what it brings, and the yesterday is already gone. So control your tomorrow, control your today, and you make your bright future. Two things to consider always: the order of importance and order of weakness. These two things you should consider when you are making a timetable. Okay, then there's a saying that to change your life you need to change your priorities. The same applies to a timetable also. You have to prioritize things in which you want to achieve your goal. For example, you know certain subjects or certain topics very confidently, so you will keep them in the last. And there are certain topics and certain things, certain subjects which are most important, which are surely gonna come in your exam. So you're gonna keep them in the first. You will complete them first. Then you can work on your weak subjects, and the confident subjects you try to put in the last. That's a very effective way to make a timetable. Does study timetable only mean study in your timetable? No, study is just a part of your daily routine. You have to fit study in your daily routine so that it becomes effective and you get to do other things also. That's the time management. It's a management of daily routine, not only just study. Yes, you may need 10 to 12 hours study daily, but you also need a good sleep. You need a stress busters to keep you fresh and keep your productivity at maximum. So how do you do that? So you have to take frequent breaks in between and do what you like the most: games, exercise, go out with friends, watch movies, go out with your girlfriend. So these things will keep you sane and keep you fresh and your productivity at maximum. And you should have a sound sleep of 6 to 8 hours daily. But you should never overdo them. You have to maintain a balance, obviously. So you have made the timetable, now you have expectations that you will achieve these things on time. But in reality, suppose it doesn't always have a straight curve or doesn't always achieve. So you don't achieve 100% targets on time in reality. So while making a timetable, don't be unrealistic and make an aggressive timetable. Don't put so much to do that which is not practical, which you can't complete, which nobody usually don't complete 100% is their lot. So even if you are getting 80% tasks done, then it's a great job. You should reward yourself. You should be happy. Now there is one thing called reserve time. We know that in life, issues are always there which can waste our time, like we can get sick, there may be a marriage in our family, there may be relatives visiting us, there may be trips with friends, you are in not a mood to study, you have relationship stuff going on in your life, so you have to attain some extra You have to allot some extra time for these things also. That's reserved time. And reward yourself after completion. Okay, that's a very important thing to do. It creates a positive reinforcement to do much better next time. So how do we do that? You don't have to read continuously for a long period of time. You have to study, let's say, 45 minutes and then take a 5 to 10 minutes break and repeat the same cycle. Okay, you will be fresh and you will retain better. And when you achieve your target or you are satisfied with whatever you achieve, then take a break, go out with friends, watch movies, do whatever you like. Then start on next target. That creates a very good positive reinforcement and you do better next time. So in nutshell, there are some tips to follow your study timetable. We all make a study timetable, but there are problems in following them. So how to follow your timetable? The things which will help you are these. You should write your goal and paste it in a place where you can see it daily. It will always remind you why you started and why it's important for you. You will never be distracted. And place a printed timetable on a wall near your study table. You will always have an idea where are you, what you are going to achieve, what are you lagging, you have to improve your speed, all these things. And don't be rigid in your timetable. Be flexible enough to accommodate the wastage factors which we talked about. And choose a study place which have minimal distraction. Turn on your phone while studying. Take frequent breaks, eat well and sleep well, and most importantly, reward yourself. So friends, these were some tips and tricks to make timetable effectively. If you like this video, then please like and share, comment on the video, let me know, and subscribe to my channel for more such videos. And you can follow me on Facebook and ask your queries to me personally. Thank you guys for watching this, and all the best for your exams and future life. Goodbye.